A Kansas City motel is being forced to shut its doors.
In a story you'll see only on 9, we were there as health inspectors went through room by room and found a host of health code violations. KMBC 9's Diane Cho joins us live tonight from the Travelers Inn just off I-70 and 40 Highway on East 31st Street with more
Larry, for us. Laura, the health department is giving tenants 24 hours to pack up their stuff and go, forcing dozens of people to find a new place to stay. Many who were staying here at the Travelers Inn got a rude awakening this morning after the health department showed up with police in tow to shut the place down.
We just woke up. They said everybody got to get out.
The health department says the motel has had a history of, quote, non-compliance with at least a dozen health code violations, ranging from a rodent infestation to mold and even bed bugs.
This is not a healthy situation. There are hazards there that represent a health risk.
Many were forced to pack their bags unexpectedly.
I'm just like, what the heck's going on? I mean, I knew there was some kind of bad conditions because we heard about bed bugs being here, but nothing bad, nothing too bad, can't get rid of.
Casey Harris says she's been staying here for about a month, waiting to move into her new place, but living on a fixed income, she says, hasn't been easy.
I'm hoping at least we can get a refund because we paid Sunday.
That's funny.
So we've only been here just a few days since we paid. So I don't know what we're going to do.
And we spoke to the owner by phone this afternoon, and he says that he's had several inspections here at the motel just this year and was even given the okay by the health department earlier this year. However, he says he has been trying to work on rectifying the problems that were mentioned to him, but he says he had no idea that the health department is already getting ready to shut his place down. Larry, back to you.
Diane, thank you very much. The health department says the health code violations date back as far as 2009. The social services division was also there today, along with ATA buses to help those who were displaced with transportation if they needed it.